a Cincinnati budget deal. It's going to save jobs, but will it put the city even deeper in debt next year? News 5's John London, live at City Hall. He has the answer. John?
Well, Jack, some say for the answer, just look at council a year ago when they vowed never to go through this kind of last-minute mess again. On paper, they're in balance, so you might ask why the financial footing still feels as shaky as this morning's tremor. It's another patchwork budget. A few million here, a few hundred thousand there. No one's thrilled about it.
But again, no decisions, sham budget. Here we go again. I'm ashamed of us.
Critics like Councilman Bortz say City Hall's jeopardizing a good bond rating by failing to bring structural balance to its finances.
Increase our earnings tax.
Councilman Thomas will float that idea in early January. He wants money from it designated for pools, police, fire, and sanitation. Right now, council has no money to keep 19 pools from closing next summer.
That's why we need to get ourselves out of this mess. You know, now how do we do that? We got to generate some additional sources of revenue.
Councilman Wendell Young says he'd be supportive. Council members Bortz and Birding have said the worst thing you can do in an economic downturn is raise taxes. A sharply split council officially approves a budget tonight that fills a $54 million hole without laying off anyone. Part of it's a line item leap of faith, hoping citizens pay a portion of taxes they owe.
It is not the world's greatest budget in terms of structure. It's the best we could do this time.
I mean, we cannot gloss over the fact that we had the worst budget crisis in memory, and we have somehow gotten through it without a single layoff or a new revenue source. There will be consequences, severe consequences to that.
And by a 5-4 margin, council will formally approve the new budget at this hour. The 2.1% earnings tax in the city has been the same in place for more than a generation. Changing it would require voter approval. Live at City Hall, John London, News 5.